Today I'll be reviewing the Elephas GC333 projector and seeing whether it's up to the task of 3D projection mapping a wedding cake. You'll see what kind of results you can expect when projection mapping using free software with a projector that costs under $100. Stick around to the end to hear my tips when it comes to investing in a projection mapping projector. The Elephas GC333 is a 4500 lumen LED projector. It supports full HD 1080p resolution and has a 2000:1 contrast ratio. My method of testing is by no means scientific or considered best practice, but I'll try to make things fair by keeping as many factors consistent as possible. I will test under controlled lighting conditions. I've excluded all extraneous daylight and used two LED studio lights, both emitting white light at 25% of their full brightness. I judge this to be about the same as the ambient light in a typical indoor event venue like a ballroom or conference room. First thing I noticed taking the projector out of the box was that it's very compact and light. The lens cap was a little difficult to remove. I powered it up and connected it to my MacBook Pro with a mini DisplayPort to HDMI cable. I've set up my projector far enough away so that it can project an image that covers the whole cake. I did this through trial and error of moving the projector backwards and forwards. Typically, you can work this distance out using the throw ratio of the projector's lens. However, I couldn't find this information online. At this point, I'm projecting my desktop background, but already I can see the pixels that compose the image. This is due to the low resolution of the projector. Now, even though in the product description it says it supports 1080p Full HD, that doesn't mean it has 1080p display resolution. It means you can send it a full HD signal and it will downscale to the projector's actual resolution, which is just 800 by 480 pixels. Now I'm opening up MapMap and setting up my mapping. Click the card if you want a full tutorial on how to do this yourself. Now I'm going to test some content and let's see how the projector performs. I'm pretty impressed with what you get with the Elephas GC333, and I think at a pinch it would do for an amateur or home show for family and friends. I wouldn't consider these results acceptable for a professional job. As a comparison, I projected the same content under the same conditions with an older projector I had to hand, which is the BenQ 1080 ST+. This projector is quite a few years old now and has been replaced by a newer model, but it is still a good projector and one I've often used for cake mapping. It has 2200 lumens, is full HD 1080p, and has a 10,000:1 contrast ratio. The Elephas GC333 projector didn't perform too badly. Some of the less detailed content that didn't feature text or intricate graphics looked okay from far away, though as we got closer we saw some issues. The main problem is the lack of resolution, which made our images pixelated and our edges jagged. With the text, some of the letters were just one pixel wide, and combined with the distortion introduced in the mapping process, there weren't enough pixels to resolve the image, and some of the text was missing. Compare the level of pixelation to the results using the BenQ projector, which has true full HD 1080p resolution. We can't see the pixels so easily and the images look crisper. Having said that, I'm not especially pleased with the pixelation produced by the single BenQ projector either. That's why I always recommend doing cake mapping with two projectors. If you are using a projector without a lot of resolution for cake mapping, you could try to squeeze some more resolution out of the projector by mounting it on its side and using a portrait orientation. But you risk damaging the machine if it doesn't specifically say that it is designed to be mounted in portrait mode, and I didn't find any information suggesting that this projector would be happy in that orientation. Also, if you are using a projector without a lot of resolution, you might think about using fewer tiers for your cake. What this does is essentially reduce the surface over which the pixels are spread out. The pixels will appear smaller and packed more tightly together, so that you can't see each individual one as easily. Another solution would be to project video content that doesn't feature a lot of fine detail, which will show up the lack of resolution. Content that is mainly composed of large shapes would work better with a projector like the Elephas GC333. The second issue is brightness. The results from the BenQ projector appear much brighter. However, the BenQ is listed as being 2200 lumens, whereas the Elephas claims to be 4500 lumens. This goes to show that often the brightness a projector claims to have does not translate to real-world results. There is a big variation between manufacturers when it comes to brightness. Don't ever take these lumen measurements as absolute. If you really wanted to use the Elephas GC333 for cake mapping, I would recommend reducing the ambient light in the environment as much as possible. In other words, try to make the room you are cake mapping in as dark as possible by turning off lights and drawing curtains and blinds. To conclude, can you do cake mapping with a projector under $100? Yes, and the results are okay, providing you create a dark environment and you don't project content that has too much fine detail. It's not possible to say definitively which projector you should buy if you want good cake mapping results, since it entirely depends on your specific scenario. For example, will your projector be mounted close or further away from your surface? This impacts what kind of lens you want, like standard or short throw. In turn, this impacts the minimum brightness and resolution you could get away with. However, it is safe to say that you will invariably get better results if you increase the resolution of the projector, and often you wouldn't want to go lower than 1080p Full HD. You probably also want as much brightness as you can afford. Buy from a reputable manufacturer and/or read reviews about whether the projector lives up to the lumens of brightness it claims to have. This was my first time testing a projector, so please let me know in the comments if you have any suggestions. If you like the video content I've been using, you might want to take a look at my shop, where I sell animations, loops, and templates for cake mapping. If you have any questions, drop them in the comments below. If this video helped you, please hit that like button. Subscribe and hit the bell so you don't miss out on future cake mapping and projection mapping tutorials and videos.